For years, Finke was a landmark on the track from Adelaide to Alice Springs. For the pioneer camel trains because of reliable water, then for the Gann Railway, which followed the tracks of the Afghan camel drivers. The town died when the Gann line closed 2 years ago. But as Richard Hun reports, it's important still for a new breed of trailblazers.
Camels still follow the course of the Finke, Australia's oldest river. But today they carry tourists instead of explorers.
Slow them down, you blokes. They've got all that.
While camels are reliable desert transport, they're pretty slow. They take about 8 days to travel from Alice Springs to Finke. It's only a 2 or 3 hour trip, however, for today's trailblazer, the enduro motorcycle.
Lever ends.
Yep.
Front brake.
Yep.
Back brake.
Yep. Yep.
Chain guard.
Yep.
Mud guards.
Yep.
Forks.
Yep.
Footrests.
Yep.
Spoke holes. Yep. Engine number of 2400150.
Official scrutineering in Alice Springs for what's now Australia's fastest cross-country motorcycle race. 485 kilometres to Finke and back over 2 days. One of this year's top contenders, Australia's Mr. Motocross, Stephen Gall.
An extremely large amount of preparation is needed on the machine especially. Not so much on yourself, but you definitely have to set the machine up very well, make sure the jetting is actually spot on, because the first section of 60 kilometres is just flat out the whole way when you're doing 100 mile an hour. And then you go into a sort of tighter section, so the jetting from the carburetor must be able to suit both types of conditions. And it's very, very hard to do.
A few seconds to go now, and it's counting down.
Seventy-nine riders from all states except Tasmania started Le Mans style in the seven classes this year. Stephen Gall took an early overall lead.
It's the sheer speed the whole way along the course. I think I probably averaged over 110 kilometres per hour on the way down. So that type of speed, and when you consider you're back to first gear on a couple of the corners, you've got to be going fast the rest of the time. And it's just the sheer speed that's really the difference to all the other forms of racing that I've done.
15 bikes failed to make it to Finke, spinning out in soft sand or shredding tyres. One rider was slightly injured.
You're only talking about a width of a car down some of those tracks and you're doing 100 mile an hour. And that's where I say it gets very exhilarating, because your branches and bushes are only just inches off your fingers, and it's very, very difficult to keep it in those tracks and keep the bike going straight.
The Finke River holds the closing stage for the first day's run, 240 kilometres in just under 2 hours for the leader, twice as long for the tail enders. With Australia's top motocross and enduro riders competing, a missed gear change can mean the difference between winning and a minor place. It's that competitive. A slight misjudgment, however, left this rider with a hard slog through a kilometre of sand. By finishing, though, he can start the second leg. The overnight stop in the dunes just outside the Finke township is essential to repair both bikes and bodies.
Sure does. We've got some little holes somewhere. Right here.
Most bikes need minor repairs. All require a change of tyres and some a complete overhaul. And riders need time to recover from the total physical and mental concentration. Finke makes a relaxing break. Day two for the 8th annual desert race, just about the last of its kind in Australia. It began as a fun jaunt for Alice Springs riders, who called it There and Back. One rider sat down to lunch and a bottle of wine halfway to Finke. Now, though, Stephen Gall's chasing a record time. Second away on elapsed time, young local rider Dan Farrell, 5 minutes behind Gall. And third away, Phil Lovett, winner of two previous Finke races. Many who competed in the first race still come back for what's now tagged Finke the Legend. They began on simple trail bikes, the kind used to go bush. Top speed for a camel is about 40 kilometres an hour, and only in short bursts. But nothing beats the camel for economy on long desert hauls. Moisture in desert plants enables a camel to plod on for weeks. And they're reliable, no mechanical breakdowns for the traditional desert cruisers. Organisers of the desert race believe the event will continue to gain in popularity for years to come. Unlike the Hattar desert race in Western Victoria, which was banned on environmental grounds, the Finke race follows established tracks. The old route south from Alice Springs and those used to service the Gann railway line. Now that Finke is virtually a ghost town, there's little traffic and no grading work on this track. So it'll deteriorate, and this could pose a future problem for organisers. While the motorbikes will always get through, it'll be tricky for the pit crews manning the refuelling stops. For the moment, though, it's Australia's fastest cross-country race, an exhilarating test of nerves and judgment.
Sitting here watching the wheels go round and round. I really love to watch them roll.
the final run to the finishing line just south of the Alice, with the 500cc machines touching 170 kilometres an hour. Stephen Gall stayed well in front and took 9.5 minutes off the race record. Dan Farrell and Phil Lovett held on to second and third places. In all, 23 bikes fell out, beaten by the desert. The rest had the satisfaction, at least, of making it there and back from Finke.